Shalom, dear friends. Shalom from Jerusalem. Erev Tov, as we say, good evening. It's been a while since I've uploaded any video, but I felt it on my heart to share with you something that the Holy Spirit has been speaking to me in the past season, and it's about sacrifice. And I think it can be beneficial to you because we are all called to live our lives as living sacrifices before God. This is the truest form of worship. So I was thinking, what is a sacrifice? So a sacrifice is something that you give for a purpose, and it's on the expense of the giver. So a sacrifice needs two things. It needs a purpose and it needs a cost. Sacrifice must have a cost. So say someone gives his life for his country. The purpose is the safety and the peace of his nation. And this is a huge sacrifice. But let's say someone has infinite amount of money and he gives 1,000 shekel, $1,000 to someone. Is it really a sacrifice? Did it have any cost to him? So we are called to give our lives as living sacrifices. So we need a purpose. We need a purpose which is God. And it needs to have a cost. So I was thinking, in the Bible there are so many sacrifices, types of sacrifices, for the different feasts, for Thanksgiving, for sins. But all of them have one common thing, and this is closeness. Drawing closer to God. This is the purpose of every sacrifice, to draw closer to God. And in the Hebrew word of sacrifice, which is korban, the root of the word actually, three letters, kuf, resh, bet, means closeness. Drawing close, karov. And I believe that it is embedded in the meaning because this is a key for us. If we want to seek closeness to God, He is already close, but if we want to take the step closer to Him, we need to sacrifice from ourselves, from our desires, from our flesh, from our time, from our money, from everything that we can, from everything that the Holy Spirit shows us, in order to show Him that we love Him and that we thank Him. And I was thinking about it, that another word that comes from the same root is krav, which means battle in Hebrew. And every sacrifice that we will give to God, if it is a true sacrifice, then there will be this voice in us that says, is it really worth it? Do you really need to give this sacrifice right now? I mean, you can just live your life. But we are to give sacrifices to God, you know, not like Cain. You know, Cain and Abel, they were both sacrificing to God. But Abel was looking at God when he was sacrificing. And Cain was sacrificing, but he was looking at his brother, and he was very angry to see his brother is more successful than him in giving sacrifice. So it's really important that our motive comes from the pure heart. You know, it says God so loved the world that He gave His only Son. So He so loved the world that He gave. So our giving, our sacrifice needs to come from love. We need to be like Shilo, so loved God that He gave God this and that. He gave up that and this. So our sacrifice must come from a good motive, from the right place. If not, it's not worth it. And I was thinking about this woman in the Bible that she broke the jar I forgot the name of it in English, but it's like expensive perfume on his head. And that was worth 300 dinars, which is like basically a salary of 1 year. And she just gave from everything she had. And people criticized her. People said, what are you doing? You are crazy. This is so much money. We should have bought it. This is a waste. There is no waste when sacrificing to God. There is no waste if it's our time or our money or our energy. And Yeshua says that she did it for His death. It's like a prophetic act. And I think that this is so beautiful because this happened like 24 hours before Yeshua was hanging on the cross. So Yeshua was going to have the worst 24 hours a human can have, beating up, humiliation, so much pain. And throughout all of these 24 hours, until His last breaths, until His last seconds, what was following Him all these 24 hours was, I believe, the smell of this perfume that this woman has poured, Miriam, has poured on his hair. And it is beautiful because we never know how much this, I believe it was like a point of light for Yeshua. He could he had all this suffering, but he could smell the sacrifice. He could smell the perfume, the love of this woman, of his followers. So I believe our sacrifice has deep meaning to God. And my challenge to us, to all of us, to me, to you, is, are we living a life of sacrifice to God? Is my life looking different than the life of the non-believer? Do I give up things because of my faith to God? Or my life looks just the same like the person who doesn't believe? It doesn't have to do with sin, it's just giving up things just to show God. It's not earning points, it's not earning our salvation, but it's just expressing our love and how much we want Him. Giving our time to Him, fasting, praying, going to that meeting when you don't want to go to that meeting, stepping on the flesh, giving money, everything that we can just to live a life of sacrifice. So that's the challenge I want to leave with you guys, and I bless you from Jerusalem, and pray about this with me as I am praying for the past few weeks, and may God bless you and much love.